Back in the 40s, I was making records, and still am, with the Capitol Records out in Hollywood. And I was lucky enough to be selling some records, and my records was all on the jukeboxes everywhere, you know. And the boss man at RCA Victor was named Steve Scholes, and he said, we got to get somebody to compete with this, whoever he is, this Merle Travis, you know, because if we can find somebody who can pick that way and sing, why, we'll have somebody to compete with him. And RCA is a bigger company than Capitol, so he started looking, and one day he heard a fellow named Chet Atkins play a tune called White Heat on a what they used to call transcriptions for radio, you know, with Red Foley. He said, there is the guy, Chet Atkins. He wrote it down. Steve Scholes was going all over the country looking for Chet Atkins. He finally found him at Chet's brother's house, who was program director of radio station KOA in Denver, Jimmy Atkins. And so Steve Scholes found Chet Atkins. He said, you're the man I've looked for all over the country. He said, how would you like to make records? And Chet said, oh, I'd like that. Said, I'd love to make talking machine records. He said, well, said, you're the guy we've been looking for. Said, you've got a lick. Said, you play a lot better, but it's similar to the lick that Merle Travis plays. And said, so we want you to make some records for RCA Victor. And Chet said, well, I sure would love to. And Steve Scholes said, do you sing? Chet said, no. He said, you don't sing? No. Said, I can't sing a bit. He said, oh, don't you sing just a little? And he said, no, I can't sing none. I can't sing at all. One thing I can't do is sing. And Steve Scholes said, well, that's too bad. Said, we wanted somebody that could play a guitar and sing like Merle Travis. And Chet said, oh, I can sing that good.